हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम सौरभ शर्मा, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट एसटी कॉलेज ऑफ कॉमर्स। और आज पढ़ने वाले हैं हम रिसर्च का एक बहुत ही इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक। जो रिसर्च के टाइप हम पढ़ रहे हैं उसमें आज हम रिसर्च के टाइप पढ़ेंगे बेसिक रिसर्च, प्रॉब्लम ओरिएंटेड रिसर्च और सबसे ज़्यादा इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वांटिटेटिव रिसर्च और क्वालिटेटिव रिसर्च। चलिए इसके बारे में बात करते हैं। सबसे पहले मैं बेसिक रिसर्च के बारे में बात करता हूँ कि बेसिक रिसर्च क्या होती है। चलिए इसको पहले बिल्ड आउट करते हैं और फिर इसके बारे में हम समझेंगे। फिर मैं आपको एक एग्जांपल देकर समझाऊंगा। मेरी बात बहुत ध्यान से सुनिएगा, कि अगर रीडिंग करने से पहले एक हल्का सा आइडिया दे देता हूँ क्या होता है। देखिए, बेसिक रिसर्च एक ऐसा रिसर्च है जिसमें हम कुछ नया नहीं बनाते। जनरली आप रिसर्च में क्या करते हैं, या तो कुछ इनोवेशन करते हैं, कुछ नया बनाते हैं, या अपनी एग्जिस्टिंग नॉलेज को इंक्रीज करते हैं। बट इन केस अगर आप अपनी नॉलेज को एनहांस करो, किसी पहले रिसर्च पे ही आगे काम करो, तो उसको बेसिक रिसर्च कहा जाता है। बोले तो रिसर्च से पहले का रिसर्च। लेट्स रीड इट आउट फर्स्ट। द रिसर्च इज कंडक्ट लार्जली फॉर द एनहांसमेंट ऑफ नॉलेज एंड इज रिसर्च व्हिच डज नॉट हैव इमीडिएट कमर्शियल पोटेंशियल। द रिसर्च इज डन फॉर ह्यूमन वेलफेयर, एनिमल वेलफेयर and plant welfare. Okay, the benefit of research is human welfare, animal welfare and plant kingdom welfare. And the objective of this research is to enhance the existing knowledge, not creation of the new knowledge, but enhance your existing knowledge. Okay, It is basic research. It has many names, many other names like basic research, pure research, fundamental research. And the main motivation here is to expand man's knowledge. It means the focus of all the basic research is to expand the knowledge, not creation of the new knowledge, but expand the new knowledge, and not to invent something new. For example, researcher might conduct the basic research on how stress level impact student academically. Okay, it means we are observing the stress level impact on the students academically, emotionally and socially. The result of these theoretical explorations might lead to further studies designed to solve the specific problems. It means we focus on to solve the specific problem. Okay guys, let's come to the next topic, which is applied research. Guys, applied research is the most important topic of the research. Applied research means practical research. Problem solving research. Practical research, problem solving research. Applied research is designed to solve the practical problem. It means applied research means apply. P bole to practice. Applied P means practice of modern world, rather than to acquire the knowledge for the knowledge sake. Okay, we are just not acquiring knowledge for creating just knowledge. We acquiring the knowledge to solve some practical problem, not just creation of the knowledge and just put it up in your mind and just bring it up. But we solve the practical problems. The goal of applied research is to improve human conditions. Likewise, the air condition which provide the cool air in the summers does not provide the hot air in the winters. So we want to invent something new that provides a new type of air condition that provide the cool air in the summers and the hot air in the winter. That is the practical problem we solved in the applied research. And applied research is conducted by the UGC, World Bank, and the public corporation. Or like, let's take an example. There is a when in the pandemic of COVID-19, there is a huge problem of the coronavirus. Okay, and the study of the students is hugely impacted, and the whole environment of the students and the colleges and the whole industry is suffering from that COVID-19, even all over the world. In that case, we have to solve this problem, that how can we make the study in continuous form, in the regular form, rather than a break, instead of coming to the school at your home. In that case, UGC formed the committee, and committee provide the solution after researching and after watching the many problems. Hence, this is applied research. For example, agriculture crops production, treat or cure a specific disease, improve the energy efficiency of the house. Officers, how can communication among the worker is in large company be improved? It means we want to improve what thing? We want to improve the communication skill of workers in the large organization. This type of research is called action research. Okay guys, let's come to the next topic. Problem in this research. Needless to say, all the researches are problem based. It means we can say that the first step of the research is problem, finding out the problem, figuring out the problem. If we do not have any problem, then which kind of research we are doing? What kind of solution we are finding out? Then we must meet the problem to conducting a research. As many as the name indicate, the problem identifying researches are undertaken to know exact nature of the problem that is required to solve. Here, one clarification is needed when we use the term problem. It is not a problem in true sense. It is usually decision-making dilemma. What is the meaning of dilemma? Whether you have to decide that this is wrong or it right, and you are confused. That situation is called dilemma. And it is need to tackle the particular business situation. It could be difficulty or an opportunity. Example, revenue of mobile company has decreased by 25% in the last year. The cause of the problem can be any one of the following: poor quality of the product, lack of the continuous availability of the product, not so effective advertising campaign, high prices, and lack of motivation in sales people. There are the most of the problems that can be responsible to decrease the revenue of the mobile company. Let's come to the next topic, which is quantitative research. Quantitative research is the most important research. There are the two researches, that is quantitative and qualitative. These are the fundamentals of the types of research. This is actually a category in which we can divide the whole of the research: quantitative and qualitative, deductive and inductive. We can sum up all of the researches, we can segregate all of the researches in these two, quantitative and qualitative research. In this video, I'm just giving a small introduction of the quantitative research, and in the next video, I will cover the topic quantitative research and qualitative research in the single separate video. Let's understand what the quantitative research is. Quantitative research means, in as its name suggests, quantitative. Quantitative means quant, in which the numbers are there. The research in which numbers are there, we call it quantitative research. The research is based on the numeric figure. Quantitative research aims to measure, here measure the quantity or the amount or compares it with the past record and try to project for the future profit. Okay guys, this is the basic fundamental of quantitative research. In quantitative research, you must understand that this research is all about numbers. Okay guys, this research is all about numbers. I hope you all guys understand. I will cover the next topic in the next video. Thank you guys.